the feature we actually want to create here is going to be best implemented using a timer event. I'm going to head back to our modeler, and if we're, as I said, we want to do something in parallel to this. So I want a timer event, so I'm going to drag an event here. I'm going to convert this to a timer, which is this guy here. Now, this is actually the wrong timer event. If I use this, it will actually interrupt the current activity after the time has expired, and then it'll actually send a token a different way. We don't want to do that. We don't want to interrupt our monarchy destruction. So instead, I'm actually going to change the type to this slightly, very similar but slightly different symbol that has little dashed lines around it. That says that it's non-interrupting, which means it can be fired multiple times, or when it is fired, it will not affect the current process of overthrowing the monarchy. Now, next we need to decide what to do when the timer does fire. So what we can do is we can drag a little task up here. It can be a user task, and this could be, and followed by an end event, and this would be something like send a letter back home to your wife. Marvelous. And then the end event is letter sent. Okay, so now we know that we now have our overthrow of the monarchy. We have this non-interrupting timer event, which we know will not interrupt the process, but we also should probably send more than one letter. So we also want this to happen perhaps multiple times. As long as we're doing this, we should relatively frequently let our wife know what we're up to. So to do that kind of sort of timed execution, we're going to select cycle from the list. Date would be a specific date. Duration would be you'd wait a certain amount of time and then you would trigger it just the one time. But cycle means that we will wait for a duration and then reactivate the duration each time. So if I select cycle, I'm going to use a standard ISO 8601 for those wondering. And this will allow me to type in a duration. We start with R forward slash PT period time 1M. So this is a lot of writing letters, but I think it's okay for this duration to say that this will repeat forever as long as we're in this task every minute. Okay, so let's save this. And again, we'll go back to our process and then we're going to stop it and then we're going to start it again. We have our trusty starting to acquire jobs written there. So we are good to go, which means if I open up my web browser and again, refresh the pages, I will have to log in again. But I should then see the newest version of my process. So let's check it out. So that's the older version. If I go here, this is version 3, marvelous, and looking pretty good. I'm then going to go to task list, also log in, and I'm going to start a new instance. So overthrowing the monarchy is done, which is nice in that old process. So I'm going to start a new one, select Lafayette, start, and then going to go through the same procedure, claim. Let's get a little less money this time. Let's go with 4,012 cents. Where are you headed? Let's go to America again. We had such a good time last time. And now we're overthrow the monarchy. Great stuff. So we claim, load variables. We now have a different ticket type, which is a shame, but that's what we're with. Meanwhile, let's take a look at cockpit. So if I refresh this, the current state of our process is that we are waiting at this point of the process, and after a minute of waiting there, it's actually going to trigger this timer, and eventually it's going to have a second token arrive here. How that'll manifest itself for the user is I should then be able to see two tasks, one overthrow the monarchy and another one that says to send a letter to my wife. So let's just wait for that to happen. And now after a minute, you can see that we now have two tokens, one here and one here. In task list, if I refresh this, we'll then see, look, send letter back to wife. Marvelous. So we have these two tasks that we can do. Now, as I said, this is a reoccurring task. So as long as we are messing around with the monarchy, this could trigger as many times as long as we're here. So we could end up with a whole bunch of tasks sending. Oh, there's a second one. So we now owe our wife two letters. So, and if I refresh this, There we go. We now have two here. So this will keep on going until we eventually complete the overthrow the monarchy task, which I'll do now. So now I just have two letters to send, which is pretty good. Now, the next thing I want to do is kind of discuss this very dangerous passage to America. This is usually a pretty straightforward trip nowadays, but of course, back then Lafayette, if he maybe didn't have the best ticket, the potential for disaster was quite rife. So what I want to add is, I want to add an error event. I want to be able to catch the potential for something to go wrong with this travel. And this is the last event we're going to discuss in this tutorial. So let's do that now. There are two aspects of error events that are important to consider here. The first is we need to throw the error event, and then we need to have something that's ready to catch the error event. There's a few ways of throwing it. You can use a symbol to throw it, but we're going to actually throw it from code. So I'm going to go back to my class here. So this is the one class we have, and we're just going to add an additional part to the if statement at the end here. So right here, after business class, I'm going to add an additional line. Let me explain what this does. So here I'm checking if we have less than 10 quid. So if we have less than 10 quid, our ticket type is stowaway. Now, this means that if I have that, I have my ticket type, but then I throw a new BPMN error. That's important because what'll happen is we throw this error, and in the same way that errors are thrown up scope, it's thrown to the scope above it to see if it can be caught. And you can see here that it has an error code called fall overboard, which is of course a very common danger for stowaways. So we need to add this additional line, which is fine. So now this will now throw a BPMN error if we have less than 10 quid with us. To catch it, we need a BPMN symbol. And for that, we're returning back to our modeler and to book a ship. Now, the only place that throws this error is this task. So similar to the boundary event along here, I'm going to add another boundary event here. But this, of course, is an interrupting one. And this is an error boundary event. So this is waiting for an error to occur. And once that error occurs, we will go up here and we will have a user task in which we will prepare for a funeral. It's not looking good if he falls off the boat. So unfortunately, we're going to just skip to the end. We're just going to go right to the funeral. Now, we obviously are throwing a very specific error. If you remember, we're throwing the fallen overboard error, and we can make error events either catch all errors that might occur. But if you want to be more specific about it, we can then throw, we can click, select the error event, click the plus up here, and then actually give it a name and code of fall overboard. Now the code is the important one. The code is what the Java is going to throw the error with. That code to be correlated against that. So those need to match. We also want a variable here because we have a message to go with this error. And so let's call it error message. Okay, so this means that whatever error occurs, the details of that error will be stored in a variable called error message. So that's basically it. We now, of course, one more time need to restart our running instance. Let's just stop it and we'll continue it, and then we'll see if we can trigger this error. So the we have restarted our project. Now let's return to our web app. And again, let's go back to our processes and see, we should have now version 4. So let's take a look at that once it loads. Oh, I need to log in, of course. You will too, so prepare for that. So we are now on version 4, which does have the error event right there. Now, as you remember, to trigger this error event, we need to start a process called Lafayette. Remember, starting a process always starts the newest version, so we're pretty sure. We then need to select in our departure, claim and add 423. Where am I headed? America, of course. And click complete. Oh no, look at this. Straight away, prepare for funeral. So if we take a look at our cockpit, we should be able to see that in fact, the token is now waiting here. So it clearly started off in prepare for departure. It went up here to America. It realized we didn't have much money. We ended up sadly falling overboard, and then we ended up here. And we can now take a look at that error message that we put into an error message variable by clicking load variables. You'll see that I have country, America, this, and we can see here that the error message says, a cheap ticket has led to a small wave throwing you overboard. Sadly, you're now dead. So that's a real shame. But hopefully that'll help everyone understand this process and help you understand ways in which we can all together work to help Lafayette in his many adventures. There's more tutorials around with using other platforms like Camunda Run, and also all of this was using the open source version. So if you want to know some of the enterprise features, there's also other videos for that as well. So thank you very much and enjoy. Bye bye.